Hello students, how are you? So again, let's start with 6th standard science, chapter number 14. Dear children, in chapter number 14, water, we will see the last video and in that we will see the topics flood, what is drought, then how can we conserve water and importance of water. So let's see one by one. Students, in previous video we have seen about water cycle, then we have seen about rainwater harvesting. But while it rains heavily at that time, some situation occurs and we will see about that situation, about a flood. So in case of continuous rains for a long time at a place, it will result into the rise in water level of river, lakes and ponds. The soil surface will get laden with water, resulting into flood. Rainfall brings about life, but excess rainfall leads to an increase in water level in water bodies like rivers and ponds. So we can see some consequences of flood. Adverse means adverse effect of floods. So flood causes damages to life of humans as well as animals, crops, domestic animals and animals living in the water. This excess water may spread over large areas, causing floods. When the soil gets too much of water, air in the soil comes out of it due to lack of air. The animals living inside the soil also come out of the soil. Heavy rainfall also results in loss of crops due to flood. So what if it rains heavily? So in our country, most of the rainfall occur due to monsoon, during monsoon periods, and rains brings relief especially after hot summer days. The sowing of many crops depends on the arrival of monsoon. Rise in the level of water in river, ponds and lakes. So this can cause a problem. So excess of rainfall, however, lead to many problems. The water may then spread over large areas, causing flood. And during floods, the animals living in water also gets carried away with water. Also, it also affects on animals' life in living in soil as well as in water. So these are some disaster because of flood. Now we will say about a drought. So inadequate rainfalls means very less or no amount of rainfall leads to decrease in groundwater level, which makes soil dry. This condition is called drought. And if it does not rain for a year or more than 1 year or 2 years at a place, the soil will lose its water by evaporation and becomes dry. Water will also be lost through transpiration process from the plants. River, ponds and wells will dry and the water table would lower down. All this will affect the humans, animals and wild animals as well as plants. If it is continuous for 1 or 2 years consecutively, it results into drought. So as you can see in the figure, you can see when drought condition occurs, see the soil. Water gets evaporated from the soil and the groundwater also may become scarce. This may lead to drought, and it's very difficult to get food and fodder for animals. We can see water as a disaster in that soil dries up completely, becomes hard and begins to crack and eventually becomes infertile. Water table goes down. Water table means level of water under the soil. That water table goes down and groundwater becomes scarce, means very less amount of water. Due to infertile soil and scarcity of water, vegetation of the drought affected area lost. Means vegetation means ability of soil to give fertility, means plants are growing, that is vegetation. So that is also affected with the help of because of drought condition. We have seen about floods and drought conditions. Now as water is falling down, we have seen techniques, rainwater harvesting, but still many other ways are there by which we can conserve water, we can save water. So demand for water is increasing day by day. Number of people using water is increasing with rising population. More and more water is being used for producing food and by the industries. So there is a shortage of water in many parts of the world. Hence, it is very important that water is used very carefully. We should take care not to waste water. And there are some ways here, you can see it in the slide, that avoid wastage of water. Do not keep the tap water running while brushing also and while doing other things also, just like washing utensils. Plant more trees, grow plants which require less water, reduce water pollution, and build more dams. This will prevent both drought as well as flood conditions. So we will see more about water conservation. It is very important that we should save water, conserve water. We should use very carefully. It is not necessary that water used in the garden is fit for drinking. But some ways are there by which we can save water. Just like, most often we water the gardens or water the plants with drinking water supplied by corporation, municipal corporation. And that water is filtered water. We should use water for gardening that has already been used in the kitchens for washing vegetables and fruits, etc. Always be careful that a water tank in your open house, in your house, does not overflow when it is being filled. Don't use a hose pipe. Hose pipe means we are using it for watering plants, which is attached to the motor. To wash your car or scooter, use a bucket instead of that pipe. If you leave the tap running while brushing your teeth, about 16 liters of water get used up. And instead of that, we can fill a mug or we can take any container, we can fill the water inside that and then we can brush our teeth. So very less percentage of water is usable on our planet. So it is very important to use it carefully. It can be done, conservation can be done by building dams. Avoid wastage of water at homes, both indoor and outdoor harvest, means at home also and outside the home also. And we should do rainwater harvesting and preventing pollution of water. By this we can conserve water, we can save water. As we have discussed earlier that we should build a dam. So building a dam is a solution for both drought as well as flood. So it can be also used for producing electricity. Built on river, a dam has high walls and has many openings or gates on both to both let in and hold back water. During heavy rainfall, when the rivers fill up, water enters the dam, and when water is needed later, the gates are opened to let out water. So by this building dam, we can conserve water, we can produce electricity also. Here are some ways shown by which we can avoid wastage of water. So if any leakage is there, so you can inform municipality or you can call plumber at that spot wherever the leakage of pipe is occurring. We should not use a pipe, hose pipe, to wash our car or vehicles. We can use a cloth, wet cloth, and we can wipe it. We can water the plants and grass early in the morning so that the water gets absorbed before the sun evaporates it. And watering by hand saves a lot of water as a water as against using a hose. Take water in a bucket for your bath instead of using shower. We should not use shower, we can use bucket. A bath in a tub uses the large amount of water. Always remember to shut the tap tight after each use. Instead of using running water for washing utensils in basin, soak them first in one tub or sink and wash them in another using a thin trickle only to rinse off. Do not leave a tap running while brushing your teeth. Repair all leaky pipes and taps. Try not to throw away used or extra water down the drains if it it can be used for some other purposes. Example, you could use water remaining in your water bottle to water the plants instead of throwing it.
Do you know Michelle, watch that 2% of water exists in solid form? Out of the rest 98%, about 97.4% is present in oceans and seas and is saline. Only 0.6% of water is fresh water, out of which 1.98% is present in ice caps and glaciers, 0.61% is groundwater, and only 0.01% is available for consumption. Hence, there is a need to conserve water. The major sources of water are rainwater, surface water, and groundwater. The water vapor in the atmosphere condenses to form clouds and fall as rain. Rainwater is the purest form of water. Surface water is present in oceans and seas. This water contains a large amount of dissolved salts and thus is saline and unfit for consumption. Surface water is also found in rivers, lakes, streams, and ponds. This water is formed by melting of snow on mountains and from rain. It is fit for consumption. Rainwater falls into oceans, seas, rivers, ponds, lakes, streams, etc. And some of the rainwater falls on land and gets collected under the ground. The water so collected under the ground is called groundwater. The level of water under the ground is called the water table. Groundwater is found in springs and wells. Groundwater is also drawn by hand pumps and tube wells. Water continuously moves from the earth to the atmosphere and from the atmosphere back to the earth again. This circulation of water in nature is called water cycle. Water cycle takes place in various steps. First, it is converted into water vapor by many processes like evaporation, transpiration, etc. The water vapor rises up, becomes cooler, and condenses to form tiny droplets which float in the air as clouds, and later form large drops and fall down as rain. Water is very important for our survival, but its lack and its excess are both harmful and can turn into disasters. Drought refers to a period, a year or more maybe, in which there is unusual scarcity of rain. Acute water crisis can have the following effects. Soil dries up completely, becomes hard and begins to crack, and eventually becomes infertile. Water table goes down, that is, groundwater becomes scarce. Due to infertile soil and scarcity of water, vegetation of the drought affected area is lost. The water level in wells, ponds, etc. goes down and may even dry up, and the aquatic life gets completely lost. Farmers depend on agriculture and thus are most badly affected. Many humans as well as animals die of dehydration and thirst. Unusually heavy rainfalls in an area causes a natural disaster called flood. Floods raise the water level of rivers, lakes, ponds, causing them to overflow the limits and submerging the villages and cities. Potable water and food supply get affected, causing a number of deaths, diseases, and destruction. Flood water damages the crops, buildings, and dams. It carries away animals and many other objects with it. Flood water washes away the topsoil, thus reducing the fertility of the land. Since only a very small part of the water available on earth is useful for living organisms, there is a need to conserve water. There are many ways in which we can conserve water. Avoid wastage of water. Do not keep the tap water running. Plant more trees. Grow plants which require less water. Reduce water pollution. Build more dams. This will prevent both drought and floods. And harvest rainwater. One of the methods of conserving water is to collect rainwater and store it for later use. This is called rainwater harvesting. And the idea behind it is catch water where it falls. Rainwater does not seep in the ground in places that are covered with concrete, roads, and buildings. The following techniques are applied to collect rainwater in such places. Rooftop water harvesting. Rainwater is collected from the rooftop and allowed to go into a storage tank through pipes. Rainwater can also be directed through pipes from the rooftop to the storage pipe in the ground. From here, it seeps into the soil to recharge the groundwater. Rainwater from the roadside goes directly into the ground through pits, trenches, recharge shafts, etc. This water can be used later. So children, don't waste water. It is precious. Thank you.
So water is very precious. Preserve it, conserve it, and save it. Catch the water where it falls means rain, nothing but rainwater harvesting. Now it's a rainy season, so we can start from here. Thank you for watching video.